to our generation that after everything that has been delivered to us, we are still the same. If the lives of John Wesley didn't have encyclopedia, they didn't have commentaries in the Bible, they didn't have anything, they didn't have a tablet, they didn't have a search engine. Today you play a search engine, every scripture you need comes. They didn't have. How did they manage to preach Genesis to Revelation? And these people with such depravity still encountered God. Today we still talk of their testimonies. We still share their encounters. Their encounters is our faith. What is wrong with us? John Wesley didn't have a car. He was riding on a horse. But he will preach in 8 different places in a day. You have a car. You are still late for church. How do we explain this? And you think God will come the way he came in their time? No, no. Those times they didn't have instruments. Yet they wrote songs that today we still sing. What is wrong with us? Who bewitched us? That today we come to church, and the beauty of coming to church is just like that. We just come, and the moment we close, we talk and we leave. Where is the call? Where is that God that they encountered and their lives were changed forever? Where is that God? Is it not the same God that interpreted Mene Mene Tekel to Daniel? Is it not that same? Where is that God? In the middle of the sea, Apostle Paul will rise up and say, the Lord's angel visited me and told me. In the middle of the sea, God was visiting people. We are in air-conditioned rooms. He's not coming. What is wrong with us? Because we have chosen not to meet him. We have dishonored him. We don't love him anymore. We don't care for him anymore. He's not our focus anymore. We have only enjoyed coming to church and calling ourselves names. My pastor is Apostle this. My pastor is Reverend this. That is all. And yet we can't have the testimonies of old. What a sad generation. We go to Google, get some information and run back. What a joke. We don't even know how to worship. We don't even know how to praise him. We don't have a message. We don't have an encounter. There is nothing like that. I don't want to deceive you. What your destiny needs is God. We have the things of God and we have God. We have been manipulated with the things of God for so long. There are deeper realms. And that is him. There are people saying, if this is true, then God should show himself to me. I want to see God. No, he won't come. The people he shows himself to were different from us. And if I see an encounter, if I see an angel, then I will know. No, he won't come. Angels don't appear to people like us. Bitter people like us. Unexpected people like us. Whereas we are coming to church and what we wear is more important to us than the God we are coming to meet. Angels don't appear to such people. Search through your Bible. Daniel was in fasting, without food, without water. Then an angel appeared. This church knows how, and we know what we are looking for with God. We know we want to see the magnificence of him. But let's ask ourselves, who are we? The people that saw the miracles we want to see today, let's compare ourselves to them. Today I was reading some of the prayer quotes of Moody, D.L. Moody, and I was shaking. You read books of Tozer, you shake. These were also Christians. At a point in time, Catherine Coleman didn't know the number of days she was fasting. You want to be a woman, your name will last beyond. Yesterday I was telling some people, there are people who die, but they lose their names before they die. Their names die before they die. And there are some people who die, but their names refuse to die. You want to be a person whom your name and your works will live beyond you. It's not this kind of life. You come to church and you don't even know who you have come before. It doesn't work like that. People of God, stop being deceived. It doesn't work like that. You want to have encounter, it doesn't come with just a man declaring to you, angels will come. No, how positioned are you? What is your heartbeat? What is your heart calling for? So we lift up worship songs and you don't even know how to worship him. And yet you were expecting him. William Summer entered Los Angeles, Azusa Street, ordered a prayer. Lord, let there be a revival. For weeks, people will come to church praying for revival. You can't try that in Ghana. You have to lead them to pray for things and not God. Don't try that in Ghana. Your church will be empty. Because people are not looking for God. They are looking for the things of God. But the things of God has killed many people. The things of God has taken people to hell. The things of God has crushed many people. It is God that takes you to the end. Do you know Judas was part of those who were given anointing to go and cast out devils and raise the dead? He cast out devils and raised the dead. Yet ended up committing suicide. The things of God are beautiful. Men will clap for you, but it won't take you far. It is God that takes you far. So sometimes he will try to test our heart with things. He will give us financial breakthroughs, give us peace a little, give us joy a little, to see whether we will run after those things or we will leave those things and come after him. Have you not read that seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness? Seek God and other things will be added. He's expecting that the first for you to have about him is him, and then other things follow. But this is the kind of church we have today. People come to church and they're expecting other things, and yet they don't see the track record that the people that go for God get many things. They don't even pray for the things we pray for. How can a man enter a city and all he led the city to do was to pray for a revival? Lord, send a revival. Suddenly fire broke out. What are we looking for as a church? Can't we see that is why God is not coming? Why are we saying we are serving him, yet our problems are multiplying? Can't we see we are getting something wrong? But who is there to say the truth? Who is there to come out? And even if we preach the truth, who will accept it? Unto whom is the arm of the Lord revealed to? There is something wrong with the Ghanaian church. If we don't come back, and some of you must give the leaders pressure that teach us the way. Enough with this deception, teach us the way. And then the leaders will come back and tell you that the way is Jesus. Prayer meetings are not complete until we call out God, pour yourself into us. Prayer meeting is not complete. There is a way the presence of God can fall on you. Favors will just come. Every human being that sees you will like you. If you don't have God and you have the things of God, you will suffer. Some of you are weak. We come to church because if we don't come, somebody will call us. That's why we come. But the fire and the zeal to pursue God is not there. There is no revival on the land. Listen, there are many. Can this cover her? There are pastors. Let some pastors go for 1 year without anybody sowing a seed to them. They'll put the microphone down. Call a pastor to come and preach and don't give him a honorarium. The next time you call him, he won't come back again. He'll tell you you don't respect his oil. So all of us, together with yourself, you too, you are in church because you want a miracle. So the pastor is here because of your money. You are also here because of his anointing. That is why we are here. And we have left the God of the church aside. That is why he's not coming. He won't come until you begin to seek him and not until I begin to seek him. We will keep entertaining ourselves. We'll be clowns entertaining ourselves till Jesus comes back. Thank God for our instrumentalists. But there are some instrumentalists, if you don't give them money, they don't play. So the reason why we are serving God, there are some singers, if you don't give them money, they don't sing. What a joke. What jokers we find ourselves in church. So if we come for prayer meeting, people of God, put your desire and your prayer request aside. Something is bleeding in the heart of God. God's heart is bleeding. Let's solve it. When we solve it, you realize that your miracle that will not take 24 hours. Let's solve that bleeding in God's heart. Can you imagine that we all run to Friday service and our desire is that today we are praying for a revival at Asamankese. Let there be a revival. And that is why we are coming and we gather, praying that God send the fire. How can we move the hand of God? I am a person who is real. If things are not well, I see. Things are not well. Let's mention it. It's not well. There are many people who are on the pulpit preaching today, saying they are doing the work of God. It's the motivation the church is giving them. If not, they won't do it. And if your worship leader is motivated by money, and your instrumentalists are motivated by money, and the backers are motivated by money, do you think the worship going on, it will attract God? It's a joke. If that pastor is motivated by money, and you yourself, you are motivated by a miracle, do you think that service will show up? The way we pray. John Wesley didn't pray like that. No, Billy Graham didn't pray like that. That our prayer, kaya, paya, they didn't pray like that. Yet God came. They saw him. They had an encounter with him. Have you not read the account of Paul? The Bible says that when he went to Asia and was departing, the Bible said, and he went aside and knelt down and prayed. Gentle. But yet, that prayer was so loud in the spirit. But we prayed the loudest in the physical. But our voice is muted in the spirit. We don't even know what you are looking for again. You want to break out of addiction? God is the only solution. You want poverty destroyed? God is the only solution. You want to break the yoke of disappointment? The reason why human beings see you and pass is because there is nothing about God reflecting. Can somebody see God and pass? It doesn't work.
Oh, I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
I keep asking myself, so can there be another Rehad Bonnke? Can there be? Maybe there can be noisemakers. Can there be kingdom billionaires one more time? The way we are fighting common titan, can God really trust us with billions? The way this generation, common tithe, 10%. The way the church is fighting the leaders, can God trust us? Except the people genuinely go before him, that Lord, you are all. The hour we find ourselves